Ujami, Uhuru Schule.
It means community freedom.
Swahili word, which means think. But what I endeavor to do is to get the young ones, and even myself and even teachers here at the school, is to start to think, to use the mind more. Because we feel that the mind is the strongest vibration on this planet. And if one man is able to raise his mind and use it properly, he can do just about anything he will. I think that in these critical times of today, that you know, we as people have to start using our minds more than we've been, you know. And with the young ones coming up and being, well, we say future leaders not only of our race but of the world, they must know the proper things to do. And the only way they're able to know them is that we, as adults, be able to teach them things in, you know, regular public schools. You know, indoctrinate, say this is that and that is this. And they don't give you a full picture of what the world is about and what positions or role one is to play in the world. They either, you know, getting educated and indoctrinated toward, get you a job, go to school, get you an education, get you a degree, and come out and be the same fool. Real school is the school of life. You know, this is what man is brought here for, to learn. And his lessons is in his relationship with man to man. Certain indoctrinations that are given in the regular public school systems, and also a lot of things in the public school system are not taught in relation to black people. They're getting more into it in relation to history and so forth, but even in the sense of the application of these things, how should they be applied, the relationship. In the public school, they talk about George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, and cats like that. Then what relationship, you know, do these people play in black people's lives? You know, it's definitely a relationship, but is the relationship taught, or are they just teaching it to say that we are over you and you are down here? What relationship are they trying to make? Why is this being taught?
We have a turn in Freedom School that we want to see our kids a well-rounded person. That is to say that he be educated to be able to handle in the situation and in an environment. That is to say that he have to know how to read and write. You know, he has to know how to deal with technology. You know, he has to know how to deal with all these things, because they're very important for development of a people. And we teach him about Nat Turner, you know, Frederick Douglass, Marcus Garvey, because these people really, you know, inform many black leaders today of what black was. Black, as we teach in our school, black is color, who you are, the gentle type, or the prototype, who you are, gentitively, you know, that you are black, which is by color, we mean that you are black, by culture. I mean that our culture is different from anybody else's culture. Black people have never really submitted to the stuff that the European people have done to white people. Nat Turner resisted against it. Marcus Garvey resisted against it. Harriet Tubman resisted against it. You know, a number of other, you know, Malcolm resisted against it. So it must not be right. Set up. They call them, they have them in the synagogue, which they kept teaching about their culture. But during slavery time, we were dehumanized. That means our culture was broken, our family unit was broken, everything was taken from our religion and our language. But when these people came over, they were able to hold on to their language, you know, and some similar of their culture, you know. But black people weren't able to do that because we were slaves. So that's the difference between us, that other minorities was able to hold on to their culture, some spirits of their culture, but black people wasn't able to hold on to nothing of their culture, you know. So the Freedom School is organized to try to bring back some of this, man, you know. And we know, you know, we don't need no PhD, a master degree, you know, a BA degree, or even an AA degree to know what is lacking for our kids, you know. And that's just a matter of fact what it is, you know. I think we've been very successful here, letting them know that they are black, and they are beautiful, and something to be proud of. But we have been taught that a nigga was nothing but shiftless and lazy. It ain't nothing but worthless but a good killing by a white man, you know. But it's better than that. We know it is. And we are here to try to correct that.
Yekundu.